KTLA Morning News with Carlos Amezcua, Barbara Beck, Mark Christie, Eric Spillman, Michelle Ruiz, Sam Rubin, Jim Newman, Gail Anderson, and Jennifer York in SkyCam 5. LA's number one way to start the day. The KTLA Morning News.
Hey, happy birthday. Here we are.
Happy anniversary, everyone. It's happy your anniversary too, yeah. In our humble opinion. We're going to go online.
You can
chat with us. We're going to do that in a minute. Oh, sure. Put it in my place. Fine.
It's actually it's evenly divided on our space here.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
So much has changed in 6 years, Mark.
You know what I think is great? After 6 years, we're getting closer to the actual date of the anniversary. Because last year we did our anniversary in 2 months. At least we're in the same month now.
We're getting better all the time, folks. And coming up today, on the 6th anniversary edition of the Morning News, we're going to celebrate with a look back at some of the best and not so best moments of the KTLA Morning News.
We also have Morning News viewers live at Planet Hollywood. They got up early. And they're serving fruit! Yes, they're serving fruit.
They got food.
Finally, they got food. They were about to, revolt. Also, we're going to chat with viewers online, as I just told you. America Online is going to work with us, and the keyword is KTLA. We're up all morning. Also, Eddie Money is performing for us, and he has his whole family here.
Eddie Money's been performing. He's already told us two or three jokes.
Yeah, right. Eddie Money's right on. And he's got the kids here and everything.
And this is Eddie Money.
Eddie Money's going to punch out Sam. This is going to be so good for our sixth anniversary.
We knew that's yet to happen. But
Real quick check of the weather. What's the weather like?
Get a shot of the kids.
We're going to do that later.
Oh, okay.
We have to do that later.
All right. Very helpful.
I know what you want.
Very quickly in the
forecast. People at home can look later. To do the news.
Very quickly in the weather, it's cool and it's continuing cool for the entire weekend. What can we say? What can we do? I don't know. It's cool. That's about it.
All right. Thanks, Mark. First in the news this morning, authorities say their investigation into Andrew Cunanan's alleged killing spree will continue, even though he is dead. Cunanan took his life on Wednesday after a caretaker of a houseboat surprised him. FBI agents say the owner of that houseboat, Torsten Reinick, was out of town, but he walked into an FBI office and answered questions about the case. There is some speculation as to whether Reinick somehow knew Cunanan. Authorities also want to determine a motive for the killing spree.
Jurors deliberating Autumn Jackson's extortion case reviewed testimony from a man who claims he overheard her being coached as she demanded money from Bill Cosby. Ms. Jackson is accused of trying to extort $40 million from the entertainer. She allegedly threatened to tell tabloids she is his out-of-wedlock daughter. The judge has instructed jurors that it is not relevant whether Cosby is Ms. Jackson's father. Jackson faces up to 12 years in prison if convicted.
And this morning, jurors in the Carol O'Connor slander trial are expected to go back to work. The panel met for 5 hours yesterday in downtown Los Angeles. Convicted drug dealer Harry Persigian is suing the 72-year-old actor for calling him a partner in murder. O'Connor's son, Hugh, committed suicide in 1995 after a long battle with drugs.
Bruce Willis and Demi Moore are suing a supermarket tabloid for more than $5 million for saying their marriage was on the rocks. Bruce and Demi filed the suit after the star refused to print a retraction of their June 10th story. The article said the couple was secretly headed for Splitsville.
Splitsville.
Anything on our American Online
Computer.
Well,
we're not supposed to look yet.
Oh.
I'm trying to follow the directions today. I'm making a big effort. By the end of the day, it'll all be blown. But hi, Jennifer.
Hi, Jen. Good morning.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. Good morning, everyone. Hello. I'm just throwing myself together here. Good morning, everybody. Happy anniversary today. It's Friday. A little hazy out here. A lot of fog. Apparently a lot of fog yesterday as well. I wasn't here. I dislocated two ribs. So anyway, moving along. Left side of the roadway is the westbound 60. Looking pretty good getting away from the 605, heading over towards the 710. Let's go ahead and go to some earlier SkyCam 5 tape. We did check on the 110. They had both sides shut down because of some police activity across the bridge here that crosses over the 110 near York. This person apparently okay now, but the 110, both sides had been shut down. They've reopened the roadway. Southbound side of the 110, though, slow approaching York because they did have that southbound side closed off. Especially the southbound side has been affected by this. But again, both sides open. Southbound 110, a little slow approaching York. Westbound side of the 10 at Dudley, we're making our way out there. The two right lanes are still blocked because of an oil spill. westbound Tenaslo from Central. We're hearing about a truck fire, Carmenita at Imperial. Apparently the smoke is affecting the South 5, the southbound Santa Ana, heading into Norwalk. We'll take a look, and I'll have an update in just a few minutes for you. I'm Jennifer York at SkyCam 5. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you very much.
All righty, bye-bye.
Okay, we'll talk to you a little bit, Jennifer. Cool weather for Southern California. Yesterday, the lowest daytime high on record was 72 degrees. We only reached a high of 77 for July 24th yesterday. That is how cool. We didn't break any records, but we were pretty darn close to it. Okay, clear skies up and down throughout the entire California coast. Strong, heavy marine layer pushing in. That is what is giving us our morning cloud. That is what is giving us our morning haze. And it really is not going to change on the five-day outlook. It is keeping the temperatures very, very cool. Daytime highs for today. Check out these numbers. 91 in Palmdale. Okay, once you get into the desert areas, it is hot. 102 in Barstow, 102 in Vegas, 105 in through the Palm Springs area. But the moment you get a little bit closer to the coast, it all of a sudden gets cool. 78 will be the high today. 85 is normal for this time of the year. And we haven't had anything up into the 90s or even into that 100-degree mark. We haven't had anything at all. Overnight lows, those temperatures holding predominantly in the low to mid-60s, 63, 60, 60 in Palmdale, 69 in Barstow. 73 will be the overnight low in through the Las Vegas area. Neil is bringing in something. This is over Whittier. Oh, look at what Debbie Fields sent us. Mrs. Fields, one of our favorite guests. And we have a clip, I do believe.
Yes, I think that's coming up.
Temperature 64, humidity 87%, barometric pressure 29.95 and steady. Winds are calm. UV index today 8, which is high. And the air quality, this is good news because it's improved for San Gabriel, Riverside, and Lake Elsinore, moderate in those areas. You can expect to have good air quality in many other areas. On the 5 day, and there you go, 78 and 79. Really not much change, and temperature still below the normal. We have an excellent clip of Debbie Fields and I when she was trying to make some kind of a cookie batter, and the whole machine went crazy on us. And look what she said.
Oh, Debbie,
isn't that great?
Thank
you.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Happy 60th.
And I hope she's watching us because she catches us on the satellite. And if she is
really?
A special, good morning.
Good morning,
Debbie.
She got
Utah.
The satellite just to watch us.
Exactly. Good morning.
A lot of people are doing
it. How many times we've run that clip?
Exactly. She's one of my favorite guests of all time.
Just quickly, it's not our fault if we're not on the satellite. I get calls all the time. It's my fault.
People are already talking Jim, online to us.
Yeah, they are. Cool. I know, we're not supposed to touch it, but it's irresistible.
I know, there we are.
Hey, Jim Newman.
Hey, we're already hearing from Vancouver, Acapulco, and Abilene, Kansas so far this morning.
Fantastic.
And Barbara, and coming on strong. And Barbara, Carlos, the stock market right here is celebrating the KTLA's 6th anniversary of KTLA Morning News, and it's in plus territory for the event. The Dow Jones Industrial Average Index now up 20 points at 81.37. The NASDAQ Composite Index up 5, bonds down 1 tick. The Tokyo market closed higher overnight, the dollar gaining in value against the Japanese currency. And it's a pretty good report from Washington, D.C. U.S. durable goods rose 2.3% last month. That's a measurement on orders of everything from appliances to airplanes. Well, gold and silver a bit higher on the New York Commodity Exchange this morning, with the August contract for gold in plus territory, ditto for the September contract for silver. So, Barbara, Carlos, there you have it from downtown Los Angeles, where we are in a party mood. Everybody down here, I understand there is a great rush on red towels at the downtown Macy's store right now. So, who knows what all that's about? I'm sure we'll find out later on the KTLA More News. That said, back to you in the studio. Happy 6th to all of you.
All right, Jim, thanks very much.
Hey, we're going to be at Dodger Stadium tonight, too. I forgot to mention
that's right. We're going to be live at Dodger Stadium on the field.
Right.
We continue the celebration
that's
at Dodger Stadium.
Yes, indeed.
All
right,
see
Jim,
you, Jim.
Thanks. The KTLA Morning News has come a very long way over the last 6 years. We've had more than our share of news stories, celebrities, authors, and artists.
But we've never forgotten our roots, especially the early days when the show first went on the air.
Southern California's first two-hour morning newscast. Barbara Beck, Carlos Amezcua, Mark Criskey with traffic and weather. KTLA Morning News.
It all began on July 8, 1991, a day we'd like to think will live in infamy.
From the Royal Ballet. Also this morning,
well, maybe.
California Highway Patrol says tougher seat belt enforcement may have...
Things were a little different back then. Not only the way we looked, but the show itself was slightly off-kilter, you might say.
But first this morning, plus a look at the latest... Talk about chaos. Nobody knew what we were supposed to do. Oh, and the thing was, we would say, oh my goodness, what are we going to put in 2 hours? What are we going to put in there? It's 2 whole hours. Normally,
it's not much of a holiday weekend for police and ambulance crews all over.
Well, we managed to fill the airtime. And a few months later, Sam joined the show, drawing on his vast experience.
But it appears that Cheers will go on.
That dated all the way back to high school.
California last year for the first time in 5 years, according to a Board of Education.
We seemed to be on our way, except for one thing. Hardly anybody was watching.
I absolutely thought, and I think the others thought too, that the show, it was going to be canceled by the end of the year. Show was not, had no ratings. It was like a noble experiment that failed.
We truly believed that this show wasn't going to stay on the air. It was so awful that all we could do is just joke.
They actually mailed the ants to you, which is really kind of strange, because you get these ants, and we got some more right here, Barbara. Plastic ants. Works every time.
Gradually, the show began to take shape, thanks to a little help from a couple of our early guests. First, there was our good buddy Dom DeLuise, who helped me forecast the weather.
72 degrees, Palmdale, way up there, 95 degrees.
Great place upstairs.
Then actor McLean Stevenson joined Barbara one morning for a rather revealing interview.
Can I ask you something? Do you memorize all this news, or do you look down on these little boxes and read it like we're on the television?
No. I memorize mine. Ron is new on the show.
These guys are like looking down like this, and you can see their eyes going across.
Right. No.
And you just comes out.
That's right. I memorize them, but they're new. They're working on it. And I always feel a little grateful to him because he kind of broke the ice for me and for everybody else, and we were a lot more comfortable with that, and potential guests who saw that were too when they came on the show.
This is one of those 100-year floods, not since 1938.
Our coverage of the news also helped establish the program, especially during the Ventura County floods of 1992.
Basically, we're not even getting the wallop of the storm. The whole low-pressure system is heading into work.
Barbara and I basically learned from that moment on that we could work together. When we were told that there was flooding out of Ventura, the decision was made, get the helicopter out there. And we were the only ones in the morning at the time to cover that news live. Once again, a big first for KTLA.
If you're home and you are watching this anywhere near that area, get out with your life if you can. You're not going to have any.
This combination of news and a little non-news seemed to click.
It is the best.
Honesty was another hallmark of the show. From the beginning, we were never shy about showing off our shortcomings.
We do not do this. We do not put on these ridiculous shorts and run around for our help.
Sometimes I feel like I'm in a college dorm. I mean, you know, it's kind of that thing, you work with people long enough and, you know, you get to know each other so well that it transcends itself through the show and when we're on the air.
Thank you very much.
He's huge. He's a mega. I feel so small.
Would you like some Thai food?
Thanks for cleaning up. This is the wildest. This is Cronkite did the news like this.
When you watch us, it's as if you've got these nutty neighbors down the street, and their house is built of glass. Okay? And you're able to see what these nutty neighbors do every single day. And that's kind of what it's like.
You are really strong!
Over the past 6 years, we've broadcast more than 1,500 shows, some 3,000 hours of live television, and not one rerun. We sure hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have.
What do you expect? I love it.
It's the greatest thing in the world. It's just, it really is. It just goes without saying. Don't tell them. It's astounding they pay us to do it. Astounding what they pay us. But it's astounding they pay us to do it. It's amazing. Because we do it for free.
Well said. Astounding what they pay.
Look at what I have here. This is the original script from the original show, the very first one. Look at all the news
in it. It's almost all news.
It was almost all news.
And of course, nowadays, it would be like a quarter of that.
The script today, Sam has it.
Yeah.
There you go.
We've just learned to distill what's important.
Yes.
We don't waste your time with news that isn't important.
News number one.
We wouldn't have been able to survive these 6 long years if it weren't for you, our viewers.
And all morning long, we'll be talking to some viewers live about their favorite morning news moments. In fact, we're going to do that right now. Let's go to Planet Hollywood in Beverly Hills, where viewers are just dying to eat and talk, I think.
Morning.
Yes, they are. Hi there, Carlos.
Hi, Michelle.
I'm out here with all these viewers. Look at these viewers. Many of them have been watching the KTLA Morning News since it started 6 years ago, and they're here enjoying breakfast and watching the show live and sharing this anniversary with us. And right over here, you were talking about that original script 6 years ago. Well, we have original viewer Sharon Brady and her daughter Heather. Hi there. What did you think of some of those moments we just recapped?
I think they're great. It brings back some memories of when we were younger.
When we were all younger, right? And Heather, you were just a little thing then, weren't you?
Yeah.
Do you remember watching the morning news way before?
No.
No? What would you say are some of your favorite moments?
Well, I like Mark Christie right now with his humor. He keeps us laughing in the morning.
Oh, yes, he does. He keeps a lot of us laughing in more ways than one. Thank you, Sharon. Well, as you can see, Carlos and Barbara, we're having a good time here and eating well, which, of course, is a tradition with the morning news. We're all loving it. See, very excited. Hi there, how are you?
Just fine, Michelle.
Do you remember that moment with Sam and his shorts?
Yes, I do. It was spectacular, to say the least.
I had forgotten how spectacular it was.
Okay, well, we'll continue celebrating down here. We'll toss it back to you for now.
Thanks, Michelle.
Okay.
Thanks, Michelle. My, I had forgotten how open you were about that.
Look what it says online.
It says something about, wow, nice legs, Sam.
Thank well.
Those are the shortest shorts, Steve.
Yeah, there you go.
That was 6 years ago, too. But anyway, still amazing. We have all these animal tales to tell you. Wait till you see that.
Plus, other weird and wacky stuff you won't see anywhere else except for here. We'll be back with much more as we celebrate our 6 years together. Don't go away.
Hey, guys, congratulations. 6 years. Wow. It seems like so many more that you've been on the air. But I must admit that in our household, I'm afraid that sometimes you lose out to Barney. And, well, then there's Lamb Chops and Puzzle Place and Sesame Street and Story Time. And, well, but you guys know that because in the last 6 years, you've been very productive. Let's see, I think if my math is correct, 2 marriages, 4 children, and about 1,800 raises from what I hear. But seriously, congratulations. I'm very happy for all of you. You have truly made an art out of irreverence. So, love and kisses, congratulations.
A lot of the folks in front and behind the cameras here at Channel 5 love animals.
Puppies.
I hear that all the time. And if a new employee didn't have a pet when he or she started here, well, guess again.
I think I did populate the whole place. Everybody's got a pet
now. Thanks to you.
An example, Gail Anderson. When she arrived in Los Angeles 4 years ago, petless, now she has 3 little dogs, or babies, as she calls them. And Gail is live from Long Beach with her babies at one of her favorite spots. Hi, Gail.
Happy anniversary, Barbara. Happy anniversary, Carlos. Yes, I'm here with Ernie, Kermit, Bert. Tony Molly's holding him. She doesn't want to be seen. And we have Donna Jones here, manager of the Petco. You're with your babies. We're here at Petco because they've been very good to us the past few years, allowing us to invade this time of morning, just as we are this morning. Who is this?
This is Johnny. He's my pet from home. He's an albino Burmese python.
And this is one of many?
This is my only one now. I used to have 3.
Mm-mm. So, you see, we all love pets. To show you just how much, take a look at our past 6 years with our babies. If it's warm and fuzzy, chances are you've seen it on the morning news.
Did you make it?
Oh! Over the years, the program has been a zoo in more ways than one.
You know what? He didn't have his morning coffee. That's why he was cranky.
From the beginning, the show has been kind of a video safari.
Yes, you are. You are so sweet. Isn't she a dog? There are just people who are obsessed with, you know, the health and welfare of animals, and those who aren't. I happen to be obsessed. I am. I admit that. I also love children, you know, but that's the animal thing. I just can't. I cannot let an animal suffer.
Oh, my.
Not all of our creatures are cuddly. I'm a little partial to the exotic myself.
Nice. My calves in front of his thighs.
Grip real tight.
Hold real tight with my legs.
Okay.
We're going the wrong way.
Okay. Hey. There she goes.
Okay, I think I got this. Look out,
Jim
County.
Ooh,
he has quite a grip.
Okay, yeah, now.
Careful, babies. Do we need some soap?
And so,
but my favorite animals are, of course, my own. And on occasion, we've put Bert, Ernie, and Kermit on the air, where they performed with their usual passion.
Bert, oh no!
Not all of us get quite as excited about our furry friends. It seems Mark has a little phobia when it comes to pigeons. And he's not any better when it comes to horses.
Whoa, 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 easy, whoa.
The guy you get on the air is the guy you get at home. And that's the, always have been like that in life. And that's the great thing about KTLA, is that when we started doing the show, they really allowed me to be myself.
That's the Grand Canyon down there.
Even Eric, who's mounted mules and tamed ostriches in a single ride, has been attacked in the wild.
Animals, of course, cannot really be held to any kind of a script. They do their own thing. And so it's funny to watch what happens when we have animals on the show, watch what they're going to do. You never really know what's going to happen. I think that's part of the appeal of the whole show.
One of our most popular segments is Pet of the Week, where we've helped match hundreds of homeless pets with new owners. So yes, just think of the morning news as kind of a poor man's Jurassic Park. Whether it's swatting flies or flying dogs, animals, more often than not, are the stars of the show.
Happy anniversary again here from Petco. Before we go, tell us about your other little friend here real quick, Donna.
He's a cockatiel. And they learn to whistle and talk and do all kinds of fun things.
Let's
like
just
that.
Talk right now. Happy anniversary, KTLA Morning News. Happy anniversary. That was incredible, Donna.
Wow.
Wow. Back to you. Incredible. Thank you, Petco, for being so nice to us over the years.
You're
thank you.
You're just hanging on her. You've got one.
She goes again.
They go on a lot of live shots with her. Like, okay, what are we doing? We're riding the roller coaster? Good.
Oh, here we go.
Takes her everywhere she goes.
Oh, thanks, but you and the birds. That must have been your nightmare.
Wasn't that funny? This was like an animal story, and then they have that like part with Mark's like, you know, like the
significant, his phobia.
But the significant confession during the animal story, they let me be me.
As we do all of the dogs and animals we have on the show.
Very therapeutic.
We have lots more stunts, a whole lot more surprises.
Plus more from Planet Hollywood as we celebrate our 6th anniversary with all of you. Thanks for being here. And
hey, guys, happy anniversary to you. 6 years on the air. That's just incredible. Hope you've had a chance to renegotiate your deals from the original ones. 6 years, man. That's great. And Mark's hair still hasn't moved. Terrific. 6 years on the air. Hope you have, I don't know, 7 more.
All right, time for more amazing feats with Jennifer York. Morning, everybody. Well, we've had more than our share of fun and festivities over the years in the morning news. Here's a look back at some of our most amazing technical feats.
Can't tell what's going on at home right now, but I'm totally back. There we go. And then I can pirouette and watch me spin again.
Give this man a tutu.
There you go.
Over the past 6 years, the morning news team has gone to practically every extreme to bring you the day's events.
I feel like I'm getting so small. Save me.
And even when we're a little under the weather, we still come to work. Who could forget the day Carlos came to the station feeling a little bloated?
I know it's only make-believe.
Hi, Gail.
Nothing a little acupuncture wouldn't cure.
Is the beginning of a non-surgical facelift. We're in the office of Dr.
And you know, we've never been known to lie down on the job. Even though Barbara once broadcast from midair. But it's outside the studio where we often take the show to new heights, especially with Gail.
We're flying high off of Balboa Island here.
upside down?
No, yes it does. Look, now watch.
Oh, there they go.
They're upside down, swinging around. Not only are they going...
I think my contact lenses fell out!
I have never been on a roller coaster. Never. First time in my life I'd ever been on a roller coaster. And for people to say, oh, she's so brave. Bull! You have to bleep that? Bull, I was scared to death.
Be brave, Gail. We want to do this again, don't we?
Stand the deck beautiful. And some...
And we're not afraid to go in depth
and again,
either.
You're not supposed to touch anything. It's busy, 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 busy.
Even if it means broadcasting underwater.
To do scuba diving, you need to take courses and you need to get a certification.
We're just watching that big shadow come up behind you, Eric. No, you haven't seen any sharks, right?
Don't scare me like that.
But have you seen
went to Catalina Island, and they rigged up this way of broadcasting live using scuba gear, and we were down 20 or 30 feet below the water, and it was one of the first times I'd ever scuba dive, so it was a little scary for me, but it was great, and we're down there, and big, huge fish are swimming by, and I'm sure it was the only time, or one of the few times, that anyone has ever tried to broadcast live from underwater.
Let me show you these. They're great.
We've had our share of accidents, too.
Let me show Ruiz.
Some stories just don't ever seem to get off the ground.
That yeah, right. So okay. Sorry. Maybe it was the throttle lesson. Maybe you just missed that, huh?
But it's $4,000 worth of damage to that camera, so he may be laughing, but the chief of engineering isn't.
He's not finding it too funny. Wait, Eric, just tell us. Were you ever airborne?
No.
Oh. Thanks, Eric. Okay.
Never got that peaceful, easy feeling up in the air.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Ready, one, two.
And we're not afraid to get dirty, either.
No, actually, Gail, you need milk.
Oh. All right, go ahead.
What you doing?
Oddly enough.
What you doing?
How you doing? You're seeding your mouth.
All right.
Okay.
Right. One seed.
Get it really wet.
Get it really wet.
Uh-huh.
Really wet. I love watching Barbara's mouth.
Wow.
Whoa.
Oh.
There you go. You guys. Oh.
Oh, mine didn't go anywhere at all.
If we're enjoying ourselves, I know it's working. We used to say when we started out that we're doing the program for ourselves, and the truth is that never stopped.
Blend it all together.
Not with that. Oh, let the blender do it, right?
Otherwise, you're going to get wood.
Wood chips in our cookies.
But every once in a while, it's one of our guests who really takes the cake, or in this case, the cookies, as Mark found out with Mrs. Fields.
When was the last time you made cookies? Look at this thing we got in here. Look what it's made. It's made one little hard ball. There, very good. Okay. There. Well, okay.
No, I've got some dough already made.
Oh, okay. No. Please, let us. Oh, yes. This recipe's been tried and true. Very nice.
The queen of cookies,
great
Debbie
cookies,
Fields.
She couldn't.
We could have ruined her.
We could have. The whole right thing is over with.
We're watching that clip, and Mark's going, "Could you not fall in love?"
She is adorable.
She is.
Sweetest
that machine person. Was just shaking, and you know what? She just lost it, and it was just over from the word get go.
And she sent us a big cookie for our anniversary.
Right,
she stayed friends with us
despite all of that.
What a wonderful person. Well, we're talking to some of our viewers this morning about their favorite morning news moments, and we're talking to them about their morning news moments over the last 6 years. And by the way, we're talking to them online also, but now we go to Planet Hollywood in Beverly Hills for some stories there.
Hi, Michelle.
Hi there, guys. Well, of course, what would it be like without food for us here on the morning news? We're here at Planet Hollywood. Lots of our viewers are having breakfast. I'm now up on the upper tier. Aren't you guys excited? You having a good time?
A lot of these viewers have been watching
since the very beginning and have special memories about the morning news. And I understand. What's your name here, ma'am?
Donna Rivera.
Donna, now you've told me you've been watching since the very
beginning.
Day one. There was a particular day that was very important to you?
Yeah, the earthquake. I have two 6-year-old grandsons. They're twins. twins, and we were all kind of huddled together in a room, scared to death. And if it hadn't been for KTLA 5 News, the group in the morning, they were scared, they were panicked, but they kept us all together, and we were not scared because everybody kept their composure. It was wonderful. Thank you. It was great.
Well, thank you for watching all this time. Now, where are you guys from?
I live on Catalina. I like to say hi to Jennifer from my roommate, Ron. He watches every morning.
Okay. Roommate Ron to Jennifer every morning.
I live in Torrance.
Torrance, terrific. Hollywood, thank you for coming out to see. Jennifer's giving you, blowing you kisses back. See, to your roommate, Ron. There she is. And right over here is one of our younger viewers. Hi, what's your name?
Melinda Gagos.
Melinda, and where are you from, Melinda?
La Puente.
La Puente. And I understand that there's a particular morning news person that you like a lot.
Yeah. Eric.
Yeah. Did you hear he just got married?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard that he took a long time to propose to that girl.
Yeah, he did. You know, we got to talk about that later. I'll give you the inside scoop. Okay. Thanks for watching. Well, you can see we have a lot more viewers here. We'll be talking to them throughout the morning and having them share some moments of theirs that are favorite of the morning news. Back to you.
All right. Thanks Michelle.
Eddie Money's warming up. Did you hear him saying baby?
He's already hot.
You on? You ready?
Already hot.
Eddie, you ready?
Can we show what's online? No? All right. We're going to be right back.
Some of the best musicians in the world have performed right here, among them Eddie Money. You're going to see some of that. And we come right back with some great musical performance over the past 6 years.
We ordered you this big birthday cake, but they delivered it to us, so we ate it.
Since we have been on the air twice as long, we're twice as hungry. How about nuts?
Happy birthday!
Hey, do they still have that slick weather guy over there?
Do we have any magic with Bob's planned for today?
I'm sure we do.
Our viewer just asked about it online. That's true. Yep. Magic with Bob is, you know, a
How
very important part of our
us
show.
Online, anyway?
We're already on. We're on American Online. The code name is KTLA. How hard is that?
Okay.
Just punch it in and you're in.
But there are no .coms? There's got to be a .com with everything, isn't there?
No, once you get on American
Online. There's got to be a .com somewhere.
Yeah.
Look for that .com.
Where's the darn .com?
I don't know.
Hi, Jim Newman.
I'm no computer expert.
Wait. Oh, boy, that darn .com. Yes, indeed.
Hi, Jim.
Hey, 6 years. Boy, this place is really moving today, folks. Well, there are certain parts of the KTLA morning news I know that are your favorites, and certainly part of my favorite is watching the musicians and hearing some of the singers. I think we've had some super singers and musicians appear on the show. Now, folks, here is a sample of some of the great performances that we've seen over the years. Great.
It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA.
Whether it's disco,
come on and wake up, LA.
Soul,
born in Carolina fields, and Georgia peach.
Play that music.
Blues.
Play that music. Play it good. Go ahead, Reggie.
Or rock and roll. Over the years, music and the morning news have become synonymous.
They try. We're too young.
Pork chops, turnip greens, mashed potatoes and black-eyed peas. My mama's cooking tonight. Ooh, mama's cooking.
I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? My girl.
More and more, it seems like I become like the music correspondent of the newscast, and I'm thrilled and blessed with the opportunity to meet people and actually perform with them. I mean, come on, Chicago, performing with Chicago was the highlight of my life.
But one of our morning news colleagues plays with their own band.
When she's not covering traffic jams, she's doing a little jamming of her own with the world-famous Jennifer York Quartet.
My music career is very, very important to me. It's why I moved out here. I left Good Morning America in New York to come here and play bass. I left a great paying job to come here and waitress and go to bass school. Not thinking I'd ever be back in TV, really.
Not all of us are quite as musical.
Give it, Joan Jim.
If I can make it there, I can make it anywhere.
Good morning, Eric.
Hey!
Like a bird.
Now maybe we should just enjoy the music instead of trying to make it. Nobody knows that better than Michelle. For all the great performers who graced our stage, perhaps the most special was a surprise visit from the king himself.
Wise men can't help falling in love. Wise men.
Oh, Mark, the best Elvis ever.
Oh, man.
I'm telling you, he became Elvis.
Absolutely. What do you mean, he?
Everything.
Who? It was you.
It was Elvis.
Yeah,
right.
It was Elvis.
Yeah. Mark, there's no distinction.
Yeah.
It's like,
what do you mean, he became?
There's two separate things.
It was really strange.
Music is a big part of our
life
here.
Yeah. Elvis can sing.
Gotta water it down. Gotta water it down.
At the same time, our Elvis is good. We're celebrating, yes, indeed, our 6th anniversary all morning long. Eric Spillman is out in the town. He has a surprise for some lucky viewer.
Take it away, Eric.
All right, Carlos. Hi, Barbara. Well, let's hope this works. We said earlier we would deliver breakfast to loyal morning news viewers. All you had to do was put something red on your front porch, and we would see it from the street and then surprise you with breakfast. Well, we are here in a neighborhood in Burbank, and we passed this home here. And we did notice something red on the porch. There you see, it looks like some kind of a sweatshirt or something right up there over that light. Hang on. Hello, is anyone home here?
Hello,
is anyone home?
News.
Congratulations, you've won a breakfast for the KTLA Morning News. What's your name?
Marie Songstan.
Marie, let's go on in and let's serve you. Come on.
Oh my gosh.
Come on inside. We've got all this food from Art's Deli in Studio City. Good morning to you. Let's just put it right here. Wow. Here, we're just gonna put it right down here. Hello, how are you? We got lox, cream cheese, tomatoes, cucumbers. Okay, now why don't we introduce the rest of your family here? Who do we have?
This is Michelle and Carly and Amanda.
All right. And have you been watching the morning news for a while?
Every morning.
For how long?
For about 6 years.
Since I think she wants to get started on the food.
Yeah, I guess so.
All right.
Yeah, we love the news. Me and my sister lives in Antelope Valley, and we watch every morning. And she said, put something red out on your porch. Are you going to do it? I said, I don't know.
Well, congratulations. You
well,
did,
thank you.
And you won. And would you like a cup of coffee or maybe some orange
sure.
juice?
Sure.
All right. Well, that's great. Thanks a lot. And
okay.
and congratulations to everybody in our audience, because you are really the most important part of the morning news. We wish we could come to everybody's house and serve them breakfast. Unfortunately, we can't. But this one viewer sort of takes the role of everybody else, and you're playing a very big role. Thanks
thank
a lot.
You.
We're grateful to you and to everybody who watches our show.
Congratulations on 6 years.
Thanks a lot. We'll send it back to you in the studio, and we're going to have some breakfast
Eric,
here.
What a
it?
Sweetie.
Who's the arm
and on the side there, the camera?
What's
we
your name?
We keep seeing an... Oh.
Aww.
Oh, she's so cute.
Actually, we saw a big hairy arm bring
that was,
some food
that
in.
That was Steve and also Gary here.
Of course,
it's
Gary.
Serve
if there's food, Gary's all over
it. Oh, yeah, you know it.
Gary's going to serve the viewer.
Enjoy your breakfast.
Congratulations and thanks for letting us come into your home this morning.
Maybe don't come back. All right, don't go anywhere.
We're going to take you back live to Planet Hollywood for more fun. 6 years, can you believe it?
6 years.
Wow.
We're going to check America Online now and check what you're saying to us and what some of us are saying back.
It says, does Mark still have the costume is the last question that we received.
Meaning the Elvis costume.
The Elvis costume? Of course I do. Are you kidding? Every Friday night.
You could have a great career in Vegas.
We're going to be in Dodger Stadium tonight and I just might wear it.
Drive Sherry crazy. That's how they got all those kids.
They asked me if I wanted one group on the show, which group would it be?
Chicago.
No question. I'd like to sing with them on the air. That happened. After the show, they invited me to sing. Walt Perezader asked me to sing.
We didn't even have the cameras on. All we have is a home video.
Wow, it was unbelievable. What a great experience.
Eddie Money said I might be singing with him this afternoon, or this morning.
Yes.
We're going to do that, what's that song, with Ronnie Spector.
It says not only do they want you to wear the Elvis costume on the field, Mark, they would like you to streak.
Streak on the
field. With and without the Elvis costume.
Okay. The computer stuff always seems to have one kind of train of thought.
I think Jennifer Yorkin says there is the best traffic gal in the whole world.
You're right.
And then another one says, I agree with you. Makes you want to take the 405, doesn't it? You guys are wacky.
Another writer
Tom Snyder, another writer from the AM News. Since when does Tom even watch our program?
Tom Snyder, whenever he's in town.
Hey, Tom, how you doing?
Hello. Be careful what you write in there. We are checking. We are having a little bit of a delay there.
Welcome, Tom Snyder.
You get carried away online. Are they really? No, they're not.
No, that's Tom.
Well, that's working well. When we come back, we're going to get the car dudes with
us. Man, they got the loudest car out there we've ever heard. The doors were closed and the place shook. So much more in our second hour as we, it's already come up on our second hour. Yeah. Eddie Money is here, and here's a little sample of what you're going to hear a little bit later on. Take it away, Eddie Money.
Happy anniversary, Channel 5, 6 great years, yeah. Hey! Baby, hold on to me. Whatever will be, will be. The future is ours to see. When you hold on to me, baby, what's these things you've been saying about me behind my back? Is it true you might want a better life? Is it true you think there's these things I lack? Think about it, baby. I'm gonna take you to the...
It is the middle of the summer, and the car dudes have news this morning about two major automotive events happening this weekend right here in Southern California on our anniversary weekend.
One is a get-together of the famous old-time drag racers and the strip in Pomona. It's a great place.
Pomona.
I got a cold in my nose, and sometimes that happens. The other is a charity car show at Beverly Hills High School. The guys are standing by live outside. Hi, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning. We have four fantastic cars for you to look at this morning, and happy sixth anniversary, by the way.
Yes, to all of us.
Yeah, well, nobody else mentioned it. We'll mention it. These are AA fuel altered. They're going to be running Saturday and Sunday out of Pomona. Everybody has to go there Saturday. Some of you go there Sunday, and Sunday also go to the Beverly Hills Car Show. We'll talk about that in a second, but first, Pomona.
Let's talk about Pomona a little bit. These are fuel altereds. I grew up in Southern California watching these cars race. In fact, I watched this very car race when I was a kid. This is wild. 2,000 horsepower, 1,500 pounds, 0 to 200 miles an hour in a quarter of a mile. There's going to be a match race between these two cars out at Pomona at the Nostalgia Drags this Saturday and Sunday. Richard Heath from Full Throttle News is with us. Quickly, tell us about the event.
Well, it's Saturday and Sunday out of Pomona, and it's a nostalgia event. You have the front motor top fuelers. They may be turning right about 250 miles per hour. Plus, these two cars are going to do a match race, and these are out of the past and actual replicas of the exact cars.
Okay, so if you're a fan of old-time drag racing, get yourself out to Pomona this weekend. Steve, let's talk about what's going on in Beverly Hills.
Okay, Sunday at Beverly Hills High School, we talk about this every year because it is the best car show in Los Angeles, absolutely the best car show in Los Angeles. And what's good about it is people are not competing for any prizes. They're just bringing their cars out for charity for the Blind Children's Center. We have Noel Blank here to tell us about Sunday at Beverly Hills High from 10 to 5. It's a great event.
It's terrific. In fact, it's the best car show, I think, in Southern California. And it's all for the Blind Children's Center and for DARE. And we have wonderful food. And the best cars probably in the whole wide world are going to be here this weekend. It's all at the Beverly Hills High School, which you can't miss, right on Olympic Boulevard. And I'm going to bring my Merc there.
This is one of your bad boy Mercuries. How many Mercs do you have?
A couple of them. Everybody's got to have a couple of Mercs.
Now, tell us about some of the star cars that are out there, because people are excited.
Jason Priestley's car. Schwarzenegger brings his car out there. Jay Leno always brings. He bought a Stanley Steamer last year. He chucked it all the way down from his place in Burbank.
And he's always there in person as well.
Oh, yeah, he's there. And he loves to come out to the show and sign autographs and see the other cars. You know, he has a big car collection.
Now, Sunday at Beverly Hills High School, what you got to do is Saturday, go out to Pomona. Sunday, go to Beverly Hills High School. You got racing on the one hand. You've got a great car show on the other. Let's look at the graphics about where and when these events are while we listen to what a AA fuel altered sounds like. You're going to hear this Saturday and Sunday out of Pomona.
Cover your ears.
Both places. We'll see you Sunday also at Beverly Hills High. And see you on the radio on AM 1150.
Hi there, morning news gang. I just want to wish you a happy 6th anniversary. Frankly, I would congratulate anybody who could get up 6 years in a row at 3 a.m. to do a television news program. Seriously, though, happy anniversary and many more.
Good morning. I'm Barbara Beck. FBI agents say they may never know what motivated Andrew Cunanan.
I'm Carlos Amesqua. Scientists discover new life at the bottom of the sea.
I'm Mark Kriske. Cool weather as we head into this last weekend in July. We'll have details and traffic in the forecast coming up.
I'm Eric Spielman in Burbank, and we're celebrating our 6th anniversary by serving breakfast to a lucky morning news family. Would you like a pastry? You'll meet him coming up.
I'm Michelle Ruiz at Planet Hollywood in Beverly Hills, and we're having our own anniversary celebration here. We've got viewers from all over, from
East Los Angeles
and
Montebello,
and a lot of other different places will have reaction to our anniversary coming up.
I'm Sam Rubin. 6 years of the biggest stars in Hollywood. Who's been right here on the desk? Plus tons of local newscasters. You'll meet them coming up.
It is a party. And it is Friday, the 25th of July, 1997.
Live, the KTLA Morning News with Barbara Beck, Carlos Amesqua, Mark Kriske, Eric Spielman, Michelle Ruiz, Sam Rubin, Jim Newman, Gail Anderson, and Jennifer York in SkyCam 5. LA's number one way to start the day, the KTLA Morning News.
Yeah.
Oh, good morning. It's a little foggy out there, but inside, we're having a great time.
We're clear about what we're supposed to be doing
inside
here today.
Inside of Planet Hollywood, inside of people's homes, we're just having a great, great time.
Hi, Joey.
Oh, look at those people.
Oh, look at them. They're having breakfast.
Eric Spielman is serving breakfast at a lucky viewer's home.
He just turned up at her house and barged in with breakfast. They're having a good time this morning.
Right.
We are celebrating our 6th anniversary. A few days late.
Congratulations,
July 8th,
yes. We're going to celebrate with a look back at some of the best and not so best moments of the KTLA Morning News. Most of them are best.
Oh, we love them all.
No matter what.
We love them, even the bows. I miss the bows. I have
some of them, you know.
You feel very feminine with a big bow thing in your hair. You did save a few, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Oh, God, you would.
You guys have been.
We also,
he saved
the first script in my hair bows.
Yeah, here's the first script from the morning news.
Something wrong here.
Carlos can't show you the bows, though he may later.
I'll share it to you online, you know what I mean.
As you saw, we have viewers live at Planet Hollywood. They're helping us to celebrate this morning, and we're serving them food in return.
The online thing is pretty cool. America Online, there we are. KTLA, I guess, is the word, whatever
that
is.
Where's the little cursor?
And remember, it was back at Huntington Beach when I said state of the world.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I said, this is state of the world. Even a surfing championship, the U.S. Open of Surfing, had its own website. And you guys all looked at me like I was crazy. Well, here we are now on television,
online.
Wow. We should have stayed on
the world.
Yes.
We are.
Look, wow, when Hologram says, wow, that hour went fast. It's already 8 o'clock. You know, we say that all the time now. Remember the early days?
Yeah, we sure do.
In the early days, we go, oh, no, what are we going to do for 2 hours? Yes, Eddie Money is here. He's here with his whole family.
Oh, the
performing
kids.
For us this morning.
His kids are gorgeous.
And we're going to get just a hint of the weather.
Hint of the weather. It's going to be on the cool side for the weekend. We're running well below normal temperatures. That's the way all of July was, and that's the way it looks like it's going to end off with below normal temperatures. And not only do we have Eddie Money here, not only do we have all the clips, but we'd like to thank the good folks from Mistral, the restaurant Mistral. They've been on the show before, and they've been kind of our part of our family here at KCLA.
Yes,
and they're cooking up breakfast for us this morning. So,
and Debbie
Mistral
sent us a really nice
Debbie Fields,
humongous
from
cookie.
Mrs. Look Fields, look at this.
She baked
Debbie
it herself.
She baked,
she
it,
baked
yeah.
it herself. I don't think so. Did you see the way she baked the cookie on herself?
If you were here in our first hour, you know how well she can do that. But
you know
on
what?
With the news this morning.
All right, we press on this morning with the news. First this morning, the investigation continues into the alleged killing spree by Andrew Cunanan. Authorities say they may never find a motive for what he did now that the main suspect is dead. But they say that is not going to stop them from trying. Cunanan took his life on Wednesday after a caretaker of a houseboat surprised him. FBI agents say the owner of that houseboat, Torsten Reinick, is cooperating with their investigation. He was out of town at the time Cunanan was in his houseboat and may not even have been aware that someone was staying at his home.
Jurors deliberating Autumn Jackson's extortion case reviewed testimony from a man who claims he overheard her being coached as she demanded money from Bill Cosby. Ms. Jackson is accused of trying to extort $40 million from the entertainer. She allegedly threatened to tell tabloids she is his illegitimate daughter. Jackson faces up to 12 years in prison if convicted.
This morning, jurors in the Carol O'Connor slander trial are expected to go back to work. The panel met for 5 hours yesterday in downtown Los Angeles. Convicted drug dealer Harry Perzigian is suing the 72-year-old actor for calling him a partner in murder. O'Connor's son, Hugh, committed suicide in 1995 after a long battle with drugs.
Scientists have discovered a new life form at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean. An international research team based in Japan found this species of marine worm yesterday. The group used a remote-controlled vessel to dive more than 18,000 feet into the Japan Trench to get the worm.
Wow, look at that.
That was just to get that worm. But anyway, new life
form. Look at that worm.
Who knows what it could mean?
Hey, Mark.
We could have been that life form once, many years ago.
Yeah,
we could have spawned from that. Jennifer York is in SkyCam 5.
Wait a minute. Maybe you could have.
Good morning, everybody.
I
personally want to thank all the viewers for watching the morning news. Your letters and your comments and your voicemails have all meant personally so much to me. And thank you again for watching us for the last 6 years. We couldn't have done it without you. All righty, 8:04. We're taking a look here at the... 710, getting away from the 405. Everything looking fine here, north and southbound on the 710 between the 405 and the 91. And 405 north and southbound through the Carson area also looking terrific here. In fact, it's a little bit light where we've been. Let me tell you, though, with a couple things working. I've heard about a problem 5 southbound in East Los Angeles. The 5 south is slow from about Los Feliz down towards the East L.A. interchange. Also, if you plan to head into East L.A. or downtown via the 101, the southbound side is starting to load up now right about Hollywood Boulevard. Stays heavy then down towards the 4 level. Heard about a problem working on the westbound side of the 210 at Buena Vista. You might find some slowing there from around Myrtle. Just reduce speeds over towards Buena Vista. And also, the westbound 10, there was an earlier problem at Dudley. That has completely cleared now. Probably a little bit of slowing through the Pomona area, but overall, it really should have thinned out pretty nicely. As you made your way through West Covina, not too bad of delays on that westbound 10 as you come up to the 605. In fact, the West 60 and the westbound 10 are looking pretty good from the 605 over towards the 710. One pocket of slowing southbound 5 from Paramount down to Pioneer. That was because of an earlier car fire. I'm Jennifer York at SkyCam 5. Back to you in the studio.
Okay, thanks a lot, Jennifer.
Bye.
We will talk to you in a little bit. 5 minutes after, or 6 minutes after 8 o'clock, here we go, very quickly with the weather forecast, clear skies all the way up and down throughout the entire California coast. The major, major problem that we're dealing with here is the marine layer keeps pushing in and pushing in, giving us those morning clouds. It is dark out there this morning. The haze is really thick. We don't have any systems to deal with. The marine layer will burn off by about mid-morning, and that will give us more sunshine later on this afternoon, but still staying with cool, cool temperatures. What can you say? Daytime highs for this afternoon, 102 in Barstow, 102 degrees in Las Vegas, 105 degrees in Palm Desert, 88 in Ontario. Hemet will have a high of 98 degrees, 77 in Long Beach, 78 in Irvine, San Diego, 72 degrees. Eddie Money's looking on very closely here. Do you agree, sir?
Yes.
He does, yes. Overnight lows dropping down into the 60s, 60 and 61 degrees. Victorville, 60, 62 in Ontario. Long Beach will have an overnight low of 65 degrees, so we're staying in those low 60s just about everywhere for the overnight lows. This is the shot we were talking about. It is just dark outside. Look at the haze. You can barely see through it this morning. And that's what's keeping our temperatures cool. 64 currently at the Civic Center, humidity 87%, barometric pressure 29.96 and rising. Wild winds from the west at 6. I'm sure at the when this is all over with, the end of July, they're going to compile some statistics, and this is going to be one of the coldest Julys on record. Moderate to air quality just about everywhere, except for Los Angeles, Orange, through the coastal areas, you can expect to have good air quality. 5-day, very quickly, no big warm-up happening at all. Upper 70s, low 80s all the way through. That's what's going on, weather and traffic right now.
Our wild and crazy news writer, Alex, is handling the on-chat line. Wild and crazy guy, if you've ever met Alex.
Mr. Fishing Report himself.
Hi, Jim. Hi, Jim Newman.
Hey, we better read those messages first before we put them on the air, huh?
We are.
All right, good morning, Barbara. Good morning, Carlson. Happy anniversary to all you folks watching our show for the sixth consecutive year. Well, we're looking at money, and our money and Eddie money is looking good on the show so far today, but the Dow Index is being hit by some profit-taking and down 8 points now. The Dow standing at 8108. The NASDAQ Composite Index up 3, bonds up 1 tick. Well, it's a pretty good report from Washington, D.C. U.S. durable goods rose 2.3% last month. That's a measurement on orders of everything from appliances to airplanes. It's the biggest increase in 5 months. There was a big boost in orders for airplanes and automobiles. Well, checking the activity on the COMEX this morning, we're looking at the August contract for gold and the September contract for silver. Barbara, Carlos, happy anniversary. More things to come on the KTLA Morning News, so stay with us and stay tuned.
All right. See you, Jim.
Thanks, Jim. Earthquakes, riots, floods, fires, unemployment, and the economy, they're just a handful of the news stories we've covered here.
That's right, but what's really amazing is that many of the events that we've chronicled over the last 6 years are the most significant in this city's history. Here's a look back.
Over the cliffs now.
Can you move the camera?
Definitely an automatic weapon.
From the beginning, breaking news has always taken top billing on the KTLA Morning News. And over the past 6 years, we've had more than our fair share of top stories.
But truly a dramatic picture of what could have happened. Luckily, as far as we know, there was no one in this motorhome that is floating down the river now.
The first major story came in February of 1992, when torrential rainstorms caused severe flooding in Ventura County.
It was falling at an inch an hour, a tremendous amount of water pouring out.
It was very compelling television.
And we found out the next day that people tuned into us in droves, that they discovered us as a result of that disaster. That disaster created what I think is the KTLA Morning News today.
Carlos, this is the Wilshire District that we're talking about, not South Central Los Angeles, third in Vermont, and we have seen a riot, basically.
That was just the beginning. Since then, we've reported on everything from the L.A. riots to family reunions.
Told them that he was walking around, it got late, he kind of got lost, he slept in the bushes, and they just found him. So, some good news.
But nothing could have prepared us for the events that would unfold one clear and cool morning in January of 1994.
And at this point, it looks like at least four homes are on fire. And again, as I look throughout the valley, I can see other homes that are completely ablaze.
When the earthquake hit, you know, when we were coming upon something, it was our first time, and just kind of having to be very businesslike, professional, accurate, but at the same time, you're saying something, you're thinking to yourself, I don't believe what I'm seeing. This is unbelievable. You know, this is real life here. And sometimes it was a little hard to detach emotionally from what we were seeing.
The Northridge earthquake was a preview of even more natural disasters we would soon cover.
It appeared to be a two-story barn standing there at least 15, 20 minutes ago. And that thing went up, and there are embers all over the place in the fire.
A year later, we were tested again when a series of firestorms raged through the Southland.
So this is the battle right here, and they don't have much time. Oh, look at that electrical pole. It's on fire, too. That transformer could blow. We've seen that happen a number of times. It's a very dramatic battle here. The fire creeping up around the other side now, back around the other side. It's surrounded on three sides by fire.
There's one occasion I remember very clearly where we were waiting
for the fire to come to us along with these firefighters, and all of a sudden it was right there, and it was flaming, and it was close enough to feel the heat, and it was very, very scary. You're not quite sure what to do.
This is a huge property here. It's amazing that the entire home is destroyed here. The home is gone. But
and I would go through people's homes and think, now, Gail, what would happen if everything you owned wound up like this? Could you handle it?
Mr. King, what happened?
Of course, there have been many other stories that didn't involve Mother Nature, but they too were
Orenthal
equally
James
compelling.
Simpson, not guilty of the crime of murder.
Defendant having been acquitted of.
So as we look back upon the wide variety of events that have changed Southern California, it's easy to see how they have also helped shape the KTLA Morning News.
Wow, six years of all those stories. Amazing.
I forgot, you know, when you're in the middle of those stories and you're reporting on them day by day, you kind of get a little used to it, but seeing it now, again, oh, those poor people.
Remember the earthquake morning?
The morning, I remember that so vividly. We all came in, and Mark, we had like our glasses on, and we were just like...
Yeah, unshaven, unwashed, we all came in.
I remember I came in, and I just sat here for about 15 minutes, kind of dazed and confused, and left.
And those poor people.
I was in the garage when the shaking started, and my family was inside, and all that started happening, and then the phone rang immediately after the quake stopped, and it was Ray on the other line. Everybody okay?
Yeah. Then get in here.
Can you come in? And I said, as soon as the sun comes up, I'll be in. But wow, I'll tell you what.
We've been incredible. Lucky this last year. We've been very lucky. And thanks for sticking with us all these 6 years. We are celebrating our sixth anniversary, talking to the people that made the last 6 years possible, our viewers.
All of you out there, believe it or not, let's go out to Planet Hollywood, where some of our viewers are hanging out with Michelle Ruiz. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Michelle.
Hi there, Barbara and Carlos. You're right. Looking at all of that footage from the news that we've covered in the past 6 years really reminds us that, you know, we've seen a lot, and as reporters and journalists, we do feel a lot of those sentiments and emotions, and it's sometimes hard to report on what the tragedies that other people are suffering. I know one of our viewers here, Michael's been watching from the very beginning. Yeah. You've seen some of the more serious stories we've covered, right?
Yes, I have. I really appreciate everybody when the KTLA, when they focus on the serious situations that they have. But I also like to think about Gail Anderson when she does her outstanding reactions with the people when she's out in the field, when she that's her more hilarious intakes that she has.
She's really versatile. She's really able to get a lot of reaction with people,
reaction,
right?
Yes,
you like her a lot?
I love Gail. I love everybody on there. Barbara, hi. I'm just going to say hi everybody on there. You guys are doing a great job, everybody, for 6 years.
Michael, where are you from?
Silmar, California.
Silmar.
Yes.
And you are from?
Silmar, the Gutierrez area.
Hi there.
Hi.
And you're from?
Moore Park.
Moore Park.
Uh-huh.
Wow. That's quite a bit away. So you can see we've got viewers from all over Southern California joining us here at Planet Hollywood to help us celebrate our sixth anniversary. We'll have more when we go back to you. Barbara and Carlos, back to you.
All right, Michelle, thanks very much.
Sure.
Now, Eric's waiting to talk to us. As you know, he's been serving breakfast out in the community, just showing up at home serving breakfast. Did you finish the breakfast there, Eric?
No, there's a lot of food here. Look at all this food. They're going to have food here for quite some time. We told people we would give food, we would deliver a breakfast to loyal Morning News viewers. All they had to do was put something red outside in their front porch. And Marie Songstead here at Burbank put out these. These are red sweatpants, and we saw these on her front porch, and we came in and brought this in. Were you surprised?
Yes, I was surprised. I was really surprised. I put out my sweatpants, the only red thing I could find in my house, and Eric came up. My daughter saw him out there with a thumbs up, and he came up with all of this breakfast.
All right. What do you think of the breakfast so far?
I think it's great.
You've been watching the news for Morning News for 6 years.
Yeah, since it started, me and my whole family, we watch the news, and we love the Morning News. It's really great.
You're going to keep watching?
Yeah, we'll keep watching.
All right.
Okay.
Thanks a lot. Thanks
thank
for...
Thank you, girls.
Hey.
Say thank you, Mandy.
Say thank you.
Thank you.
They are so cute. We have some of the greatest viewers in the world, and we want to thank all of you for watching, and all the people who we couldn't bring breakfast to, we apologize. Maybe next time. Back to you in the studio.
She's got to be about two because she does it, but she says no.
No, thanks. No. I want to just take a nap.
She's got right that now. Look on her face.
Yes. We'll see, Eric.
Okay, Eric. Well, what do Howie Mandel, Andy Rooney, and Paula Abdul have in common?
We don't know. But anyway, see famous people doing outrageous things when we come back.
From all of us to all of you, a very happy anniversary.
And best wishes for continued success. Zany bunch of knuckleheads.
Mike.
There's our makeup artist, Kelly. Couldn't live without her. We are not only celebrating our 6th anniversary here in the studio, we've also taken our party to the people.
Yes, and Michelle is live at Planet Hollywood in Beverly Hills, where dozens of folks are eating on us and them. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Michelle.
Hi there, guys. I'm here with some of our loyal viewers, 6-year-old Lauren, right, Lauren?
Mm-hmm.
Where are you from, Lauren?
Agudelce.
Now, you told me earlier one of your favorite people on the morning news. Who's that?
I forgot.
Didn't you tell me it was Mark?
Mark,
yeah, Mark Kriske. He's pretty, see, he's waving to you. Did you
How
see him
are
wave
you?
To you?
Good morning.
And this is Ryan. Ryan, where are you from?
Yeah.
From here? From South Palm, I think you told me a little earlier. Is that right? You know, no? Okay. Well, you've been here celebrating with us our 6th anniversary, and we're at Planet Hollywood, where, of course, it's known for memorabilia of famous people, and we've had our share of famous people join us on the show. We've had leading celebrities, politicians, athletes, and artists, and here's a brief look at some of the famous people who've joined us over the past 6 years. During the past 6 years, we've had our share of celebrities and newsmakers. But what's really amazing is that all of them not only get up at the crack of dawn, they actually appear for free.
Good morning. We're so glad you're here.
I'm so happy that I'm here, especially for what you're paying me, and I think it's terrific.
Jackie Mason joins us this morning. Good morning. We're glad you're here.
Why not? For nothing, you'll take anybody.
What gets you up this early, Don? Even though you're like a block away, you should come in.
Well, there was a rumor that your show might catch on.
One thing that I think we still pride ourselves on is because of the comfortable nature of the show, I think the stars are more candid here, more candid on the morning news than they are anywhere. You and your husband, and I mean this in the best way, on a flight, were all over each other. It was great. No, but you were a total handle. It was very romantic.
Well,
is the honeymoon still happening?
Do you know that he passed gas? I said, stop it. I think I know this person next to me.
I mean, Richard is...
I hear it.
Is it hard to follow Richard Simmons?
I don't want Richard Simmons following me. I mean that in a nice way.
Yes.
I meant that in a nice way. I just didn't want to... I'm gonna.
What have I done to you?
Nothing.
I walked into the green room. I offered you a bagel. I hugged your mother.
You did.
What's the problem?
There is no problem, Richard. I love you. My wife's watching, and probably that's the end of my marriage. But it's you I love.
You know when something's working, and you get a feel for it. We never know where the show's going to go or what the theme is going to be. And a lot of days, the show all of a sudden picks up a theme.
Oh, you know what? You're disappearing, aren't you?
I am.
No, you're.
Yes,
yeah,
I am.
You're past. You know, you have a problem there, Mr. Cosby, and I...
Well, my wife will be happy to hear that. I've been a demon lately this morning.
Yeah,
yes. What happened to the weather?
You've been eating too much of that Jello, and it's kind of...
Yes,
yeah.
This is
We've also tried to bring you people who make news.
The people who oppose pornography usually are very insecure about their own sexuality.
To finally get to the point that I would hear the jury actually acquit him, given the overwhelming amount of evidence, in my opinion, that points to his guilt, it was traumatic.
Now, some assemblymen have been heard to say that the governor's a wimp. He blinked. Did you?
No, only one said that, and I think, to be charitable, nobody pays much attention to him.
And occasionally, we feature people who actually cover the news.
I remember when we first at KNBC put on the 5 o'clock news to be buttered up against the 6 o'clock news. We thought, you know, who's going to watch a 2-hour block of news? And discovered a lot of people will do it.
Well, I knew from college that I wanted to be a writer and a journalist.
Well, that answers that. It was a plan, wasn't it?
Well, I'm not Charo, you know. I mean, I don't play anything. I answer a question.
You had to do something.
I've had this extraordinary schizophrenic image. You know, I have this analyst, commentator, lawyer at night, and the kind of ringmaster image during the daytime, you know, kind of presiding over a freak show. And, you know, I think both those images are probably exaggerated, and I'd like to tell people that's just really only one of me.
Coming here, of course. We've had royalty appear on the show. Kings, presidents, presidential wives, and even vice presidents.
Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to see you. Here's the one right here. He said, there he is, like some alien had just come into the studios. That's him.
That was a blast. The vice president was standing behind our cameras in between commercials, joking with us, and there are all these Secret Service men standing around. It was surreal. And here he was, you know, making jokes and having a good time with us. That was an experience.
That was, yeah, vice president. Yes, sit down. You can sit down on our seat. Yes.
And we did that commercial.
The commercial with him, too.
Yeah, the Murphy Brown.
Ones, exactly.
And Mark missed the knot by half a second.
Oh. That was great.
It's still missing.
Watch Murphy Brown on Channel 5, knot.
Because, you know what, I forget all the wonderful times we've had. It's wonderful to see that. Hi, yeah. Michelle.
You're hi there, Barbara there? And Carlos. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Oh, yeah,
sorry.
You're right. You mentioned all these wonderful times we've had. We forget how many wonderful times we've had. I'm here with Michael Roth. We've been here at Planet Hollywood, of course, known for Famous People memorabilia, and I understand you want to help celebrate our 6th anniversary.
Absolutely. We looked up in the encyclopedia, what gift do you give for the 6th anniversary? It turned out to be something with a logo of a theme restaurant on it. So,
oh, really? Oh, okay.
So I went into our merchandise store, I found a couple
very
things.
Smart.
A little too warm in the summer for jackets, so we've got these new skinny tees. We wanted to let all the ladies have these, and also, or a hockey jersey. We get ready for the fall.
Wow.
So this is for the Channel 5 staff. And of course, Jennifer needs this for the helicopter.
That's right, she does need that.
And lastly, we saw Sam Rubin this morning. I know, since this is how he broadcasts the news.
Action.
Sam, we would be very proud if you wore this. In fact, he should stand up
Sam,
right now.
That's right. Monday, Sam. This is it. Come Monday.
Michelle, tell Michael I have a pair of them on right now.
He says he has a pair of them on right now. Well, Monday we want to see them, Sam. Thank you, Michael.
Thanks a lot for coming to Beverly Hills, and we hope you come back all throughout your 6th anniversary.
Oh, thank you. You've been very kind to us. Bye-bye. And looking to all these wonderful viewers who are joining us here this morning as we continue celebrating our 6th anniversary live here at Planet Hollywood.
Don't you want to be there?
Oh, I know. Great fun.
We'll see you, Michelle.
Thanks, Michelle.
Just ahead, the morning show hits the road.
When we come back, the exotic places we have all visited. Don't go away.
Uh-oh, Fiji, right?
I just want you to know that you are my newscast of choice. I cannot get through a morning without watching Channel 5, seeing Gail go down a water slide or Jennifer Ruff in that helicopter. And Sam, I depend on you to tell me what I'm doing with my life. So I just want you to know you've got a viewer.
Well, good. I've never actually woken up early enough to see the show, but I hear it's terrific, and I'm going to start.
Barbara Mark, they're great.
Yeah, you know, that's 6. It's a fine anniversary number, but not nearly as cool as
the 9.
Are you ready to rock and roll? We can't hear you. Are you ready to rock and roll?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our dad, Mr. Eddie Money.
Thank you so much. Great job, kids. I want to go to Hawaii with the Eddie Money Band. Especially for Channel 5, something that all of us have always wanted to do. Yeah, you waited so long, you waited so long, you waited so long, you waited so long. I'm gonna take so far from here. Take it to Los Angeles, California. I've got 2 tickets in my pocket, baby. We're gonna disappear. You know why? You waited so long. Waited so long. Waited so long. Waited so long. I've got 2 tickets to pass.
Right.
Not to mention the two cutest little boys in the world. Look at those two guys.
That's two of the gang. There are more.
Welcome our dad, Eddie Money. That's so cute. For the last few months, we here at KTLA have had a site on America's Online. It's called America Online, Digital City LA. And today we're hosting a live chat that you can see on the screen that we've been talking with some of the...
they say, Carlos, stand up.
Oh, okay, I'll stand up. Here we go.
Yeah. Show us those long legs. Yeah, they want to see your booty.
No booties today. Yeah, there you go. Barbara, have a seat here. Actually, we have a computer here and we're talking with you. The keyword is KTLA. Let me just write here really quickly.
That's pretty simple. KTLA. That's
very easily. No dot coms.
You have to think.
No booty calls today, okay?
Are we ever going to show that beautiful cake that we got from
We've got a cake right here. Let's take
a
look.
We've got so many anniversary gifts.
There it is, right there. The WB.
Are we showing it? We're trying.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, here it is.
How about a jean check, Carlos?
Yeah, well, I'm wearing my jeans right here.
His jeans and his boots.
I've got the dark jeans. I've got the dress jeans.
Yeah.
These are the dress jeans I wore for
and his good booties
General
too.
Powell.
Wow.
Powell when he was here.
Oh, so those are
you know, I wanted to show respect.
And Carlos had the general sign nice the jeans.
And the clean booties.
The clean booties.
Do they have the cake? Because we can tell you the, you know, because Mark and I have both taken trips to Solvang.
We've all been there.
It's 3 minutes later there, right?
So at 8:35, good morning to Solvang and our friends at the Solvang Bakery. The Solvang Bakery for the custom cake.
Okay, now we've shown it. Can we cut it?
It's also Alyssa Christia Duclos from Morro Bay. She's celebrating her sixth birthday.
Aw, what a coincidence.
And, you know, one thing I'd like to say is thanks to our families for putting up with us.
Absolutely.
I mean, my wife puts up with me getting up at 3:30 every morning as I wake her up when the alarm goes off. And
my
staying up late, you know, everyone
nice
wants to stay
it.
Up late. We have to go to bed early. But
just this morning, my Sherry said, "Why didn't you close the door?" That was the first words I heard.
You have a lot to put up with.
It's so funny. Julie said, "Happy anniversary. Close the door."
Did you really? Don't let it hit you on the way back.
Don't let it hit you.
Sherry didn't even say happy anniversary.
I'm so sorry that I don't have someone there to say that to me.
Eric does now, though.
Eddie Money, and we're back in 2 minutes.
Alyssa Duclos, happy birthday. We just said that. And David Vincoletti. Hello.
Virtual cake. That's funny.
Thanks, Mary. Thanks,
but Curl does.
Eddie Money coming up next. Don't go away. Six years of the morning news would not have been possible without our viewers, all of you. In a way, you could blame yourselves for all of this.
We're always ready to pass the blame. I didn't do it. They did it. We're going to hear from some of our viewers once again. They've gathered around Michelle Ruiz at Planet Hollywood in Beverly Hills.
And all around their computers on America Online as well as we continue to. Mark has created his own religion, the House of Elvis or something.
If you're
with us online.
Meeting
at the House of Blues. By the way, we're going to be at Dodger Stadium tonight.
And
the Dodgers are hosting. Who's playing, Carlos?
I don't know.
Philadelphia, I do believe it is.
Yeah, I guess
Philadelphia, and we're going to be there just before the game. They're going to introduce us and wish us a happy anniversary, and we're going to come out on the field.
Isn't that nice?
We'd like to thank the Dodgers.
And then we get to sit in the bullpen.
Sit in the bullpen?
No.
That would be too good for us.
I know.
They want you to stand up.
They want me to stand up again?
No, Mark.
Mark to stand up.
They want Mark to stand up.
Okay, I will stand up.
This is from America Online.
He needs to sing. Sing
more. I can't, you know, take me home tonight. I want to do the Ronnie Spector version on Eddie Money's song. I want to be the Ronnie. Be my little baby.
Well, that's why he doesn't sing.
Exactly.
Hi, Michelle. How are you?
Okay.
Hello.
Okay.
Hey, good morning.
Hi.
All right. I love you guys. I'm one of your original KTLA Morning News viewers, and I'm also, Mark Kreske and I have the same something in common. We have the same voiceover agent, Steve Tishman, the best guy in the world.
Hey, all
yeah,
right.
Yeah, we go back, Mark, and I tell you, my buddy and I, Reggie, were jogging this morning 7 miles, and I turned around, took a bath, and came back here just to be with you, all right? And with some viewers here. Hey, do you love KTLA?
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Everybody love you. What about you?
I like it.
Hey, see, you know you love. And Michelle,
my job?
No, I wish you weren't married. I would like you, but then that's what you
Thanks for covering me. I had to go to the restroom, you know, and they covered me, you know. But you did a great job.
Thank you very much.
And what's this little girl's name? She's so sweet.
Jessica.
Hi, Jessica. Are you one of our biggest viewers?
Yeah.
She goes, what is this? Thanks for watching. Where are you guys from?
Long Beach.
Long Beach. Terrific. Okay.
Yes, you're from?
Long Beach.
They're from Hollywood.
We're from Hollywood.
You guys are big fans, I can tell.
This is
Daddy Warbucks.
Yeah.
Daddy Warbucks look-alike.
Hi, nice to meet you.
You
want to adopt me?
Get the adoption papers ready.
Okay. All right, we can talk later. Now, you said you have actually family members who watch in Denver, right?
Denver, yes. My brother, he'll be watching this, and I hope, I don't know if he'll be recording it or what, but I'm hoping somebody will record it because I'd love to get a copy
What's
of this.
What's his name?
Steve Aboud.
All right. Hi, Steve.
Hey.
Hi, Steve in Denver.
Hi, Steve. All right, Michelle.
Okay.
Thanks so much.
Thanks so much.
Our home base, as you well know, is in Hollywood, right here at the KTLA studios, but we often make the world our news set, traveling to places, as Star Trek Captain Kirk used to say, where no man has gone before.
Gail is on the road every day for the KTLA Morning News. Here she is.
Morning news may call Los Angeles home, but over the past 6 years, we've often stepped out of the studio for an excursion to the exotic. Always on the lookout for the unusual.
And these catwalks literally allow you to walk almost right into the falls. You do get a bit wet, but it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Wow.
The stones here at Stonehenge behind me are anywhere between 3,000 and 4,500 years old.
Do you sing at all? You don't sing. I'm sure people ask you that all the time, though, huh? No sing. Well, no sole mio, oh sole mio. No? No?
It might seem glamorous, but we usually carry our own bags.
All righty. I'm fine.
We stay in first-class accommodations.
What do I tell you, huh?
We often supply our own transportation.
Look out, look out. Oh my God.
And we're always careful to honor the local customs.
Cobra. Cobra. Very, very poisonous.
Especially when it comes to sampling the cuisine.
Snake soup?
Yeah.
Okay, snake soup for one.
I think I'm...
Salute. Salute.
We've got squid, we've got octopus. Mark, if you had hands like this, you could point to every place on the map and maybe get it right.
So whether it's Venice or Vietnam, South Dakota or South Africa, Graceland or even Opryland, we hope it's been entertaining and maybe even a little enlightening.
The steps get bigger and bigger.
It certainly has been for us.
Walking on the Great Wall of China was definitely a great moment. And the wonderful thing was, it was at the end of the day, it was our last shot. The sun was setting, and it was just such a beautiful evening, and all of a sudden, everything seemed to go quiet and still, and we actually had some time to spend up there, because usually when you go on these trips, you're in and out, bang, bang, get the shot. That was amazing.
But maybe the best trips have been when we stayed right here at home. You know, when we visited various sites in Southern California by taking the entire show on the road.
We're live from Lake Arrowhead, and yes, someone is water skiing up here.
Can you believe this? Let him come around again.
Yeah, can't wait to get my board out. Yeah.
Wax it up.
Yeah.
I'm Carlos Amasco, and we're coming live from Mexico. Today, we'll discuss Mexico's role in world trade.
Live aboard the USS Kitty Hawk in San Diego. We continue our journey right here in port aboard this amazing ship.
The Dodger Stadium, we are.
It's a chance to bring the show directly to the city and to get to know you a little bit better.
It's amazing to me every time I'm out how many people come up to me and really feel like we're a part of their day and, you know, feel like they know us as friends.
Good morning, I'm Barbara Beck. The first ever, hopefully annual, Morning News Block Party.
Recently, we tried something a little different. We invaded an entire neighborhood in Long Beach for a two-hour block party.
The Morning News has taken over this block. Of course,
the response was so positive, we're going to try it again. And your neighborhood could be next.
The Morning News, of course, is a team effort and requires the help of dozens of people behind the scenes.
So we thought we'd give you a brief look at how somehow every day we manage to get the show on the air and the people behind the scenes who really make it happen. Work begins early on the morning news, real early. By 2 a.m., a host of producers and our famous angry news writers are busy preparing the broadcast. Deadlines are often tight, and sleep is always in short supply.
It's not like you're like, I wake up and I'm bouncing out of bed and ready to go. I mean, I like roll over and fall out of bed, trudge to the bathroom, and kind of, you know, it takes me, you know, by the time I've washed my face and I'm kind of waking up, and you just get used to that groggy feeling you have every time that alarm goes off at 3:45.
Are you awake?
But most of us can't wait to get to work.
Good morning.
You have 5 minutes?
Okay, thanks, Harold.
Sure.
Let's go to work!
Studying the
By the time the show starts, most of the segments and skits have already been assembled by producers like Tony Molly and Bonnie Teagle.
But much of what goes out on the air seemingly comes out of midair because the majority of the show is entirely unscripted.
Let's have a look at some of the numbers.
Rap, please.
Now I'm getting the audio rap. Ray Bruni, our producer. We have another producer called Steve Weekly, who isn't as kind to us. Get him off the air. He's got a very heavy South accent. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the big time rap. Barbara Carlos.
Chemistry, I kind of hate to use that word because it's such a talent word for news. And, oh, let's put these two together, you know, Sandy and Bill, and see if they have chemistry. I hate to use that because it's something else. It's something more than that. We genuinely like each other and care about each other.
But every day, it's always a team effort.
All the time.
Well, high math.
I'm so proud of my team.
With the four of us out there, there's some days where we sit back and all of a sudden Barbara or Carlos or I'll go, you know what? I'm dead today. You guys have to, you know, work the show, and everybody's ready to pick up the slack.
But this is her first big trip. And so,
She'll be back in a month, though. She'll be back on the air every month.
Oh, no! He just hit her in the head with the microphone!
I didn't hit her!
Look, she's crying! Oh, cut away! This is getting ugly!
This is terrible!
You know,
Now, if you're wondering where some of the so-called content of the morning news comes from, a good bet is the control room, where our great director Len Goodside resides.
Cut!
All that kind of funny stuff that we are surprised about, well, it's no surprise to Len because he's the one who put it on. He's an integral, vital, I can't overstate. People think, and it's a mistake, they think, oh, it's Carlos, Barbara, Mark, and Sam. There's a lot more people involved.
Here's what's happening right here. You can see clearer skies all the way through, but securities. They're throwing stuff.
And I'd like to go on record right here and now saying these are my gags, folks.
It's
my stuff, and they just read it. Did you see broadcast news where it goes in one ear and out? That's exactly the same thing here. I tell them everything, comes right out. And they all laugh, and they think they're funny. It's me, folks. It really is me.
There are, of course, many other characters who help shape the show. Magic with Bob is really Bob Maislin, one of our cameramen. And then there's Neil Levine, our infamous stage director.
I caught you with Richard Simmons.
Good morning, I'm Carlos Amesco. Mike Tyson goes on a Ferrari.
So as the morning news embarks on year 7, we'd like to thank you for watching. And also thank our colleagues and friends behind the scenes for making sure the show actually gets on the air today and every day.
We're so thrilled he's here. He's celebrating his 20th year in music. And since we're celebrating our 6th anniversary, we thought, hey, this will work perfectly. And we've invited him to join us right here on the morning news. Ladies and gentlemen, one of our favorites, Eddie Money.
Thank you, Mark.
Hey, how you doing?
Mark, I brought you these Eddie Money. We got to get the band back together, Shades, because you're always clowning around and give us another prop.
These are very cool. These are so cool. Thank you very much. Now, 20 years in the music biz, did you ever anticipate when you came out with your first hit that it would last this long?
Well, you know, I've always been in a rock and roll band. I quit the police department because my hair was getting really good in the back. You know? I moved out to California. We did Baby Hold On and Two Tickets to Paradise on the first record. And I don't know. People like to, God bless me with a lot of hits, and it's just great to be able to keep on rolling. We got a new record deal with CMC. And we're very excited. We're putting out a live record with all, it's called Nothing But the Hits, 20 Years of Shaking with the Money Man. And come on down to Santa Ana. We're going to have a lot of fun down there.
Right there. If you want to be part of a video and part of the making of an album, it is happening on July 30th and 31st. That's this Wednesday and Thursday at the Galaxy Theater in Santa Ana. Showtime is at 8 o'clock. More information is available right there or by calling the KTLA hotline. Let's get to it. What are you going to sing right now?
Take me home tonight.
Oh, my favorite, Eddie Money.
You got room in the car for me? Tries to keep a man awake at night. Are you the answer? I should wonder. When I feel with my appetite, with all the power to release it, it is safe to walk the city streets alone. Anticipation running through me. Let's find the key and turn this engine on, yeah. I can feel you breathe, I can just like Ronnie say.
Be my little baby, baby, my darling love.
Hey. I get frightened in all this darkness. I get nightmares, I hate to sleep alone. I need some good stuff to get a sitter, to keep a warm when the cold winds blow. I can feel you breathe, I can't.
All right, Sean. Yeah,
well, excellent.
Gilles. I'm sorry. Did I say Gilles? Yeah. Good grief.
Oh.
Mark, you have a microphone. Oh, I have the microphone here.
Well, now Mark's on camera. Wait a minute. Are you on camera or am I on camera? Who's on camera? We on? Which camera? Okay. Here we go. Here we go.
Okay. All right. Joining us is. Yeah. Joining us is Gilles from Mistral. Gilles, you've been on the show. You cooked us a meal once. You came and did a Christmas for us, and it's just a 6th anniversary, and it wouldn't be the same without having you guys here today.
Thank you. We are very happy to be there for your 6th anniversary.
Okay, now what have you cooked for us this morning? If we could get the Barbara, Carlos, and Sam out of the way for a second. what have you made for us this
morning?
Well,
you know, it's kind of a cool weather today, so we have the gratin potatoes and a beef bourguignon on the other side, which is a beef stew, and we have a vegetable tart, some little salad, and a marinated salmon, which is the trademark of the restaurant.
Oh, and it is all so good. We thank you for joining us. Where is the restaurant located, Mistral?
It's 13422 Ventura Boulevard.
And that's in
Sherman Oaks.
Sherman Oaks, okay.